And this is what it all comes down to, playoff basketball. Both Union teams tonight are number one seeds in the 3A tournament, and they get to host games back to back. First with the Lady Cougars taking on the Pineview Panthers, a long bus drive all the way from St. George up here to Roosevelt, Utah. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Brian Baldwin along with Brandon Jones. This is the B&D RV pregame show, and this is going to be a great matchup tonight because Pineview, I mean, to win a playoff spot in that St. George division is a big accomplishment. So Pineview's not coming here as like a four seed like you typically think. A four seed is definitely the underdog to a one seed. This is going to be a good game, Brandon.
Yeah, they're definitely a high-scoring team. And then you got Union on the other side. I don't even know how long it's been since they've been a host of the region here. So they're really excited and ready to play.
Well, I can tell you the last time I believe that the Lady Cougars hosted a game here was against the Cedar Reds. And I think that was back in 2009 or 10. I remember that team very well. It was exciting. That Union team that year went to the state championship game. I believe they lost that game, but it was definitely an exciting year then. So if this team can live up to the team that was performing well on the floor then definitely exciting times for Roosevelt. And you know what? Two home games on a Friday night, and both these games are basically one and done. So there's so much riding on them.
Definitely. Yeah, how many teams do you have both times in the region playoff playing on the same night? It's pretty exciting.
Yep, so the pregame show brought to you by B&D RV. B&D RV supplies the Uinta Basin with the best in RV sales, RV rental, and RV service. Whether you are looking for your first RV or your last, B&D will assist you in your purchases. Stop in at 1570 West, Highway 40 in Vernal to check out our on-the-lot inventory, B&D RV. Now, we have the starting lineups here for both teams, and we also have some keys to the game for the Union Cougars. But before we get to Union starting lineups, let's talk about Pineview and the Panthers. Saravin Allen is going to be number three you see on the court, a sophomore. Sarah Pierce, a senior, wearing number five. Claire Newby, a sophomore, wearing number 10. Tavia Akeen is my best guess on how to pronounce that. She is a senior, wearing number 24. And then Brianna Moe is what I'm going to say there, because I'm not sure how to pronounce that either. She's a junior wearing number 33. Now, for the Union Cougars tonight, Brandon, the keys to the game, they say we have to rebound the ball. They go to the glass hard, speaking of Pineview.
Yeah, they definitely got to win the turnover battle as well. They got to get good pressure on the ball, and they do a really good job at that. They get on the ball really well. Pineview struggles with pressure, and so that's what they need to influence that way. So look forward to have a good game with both these teams that are very similar, but you got one player on their team that shot 43 threes and made them this year. So, I mean, they can score.
Yeah, they can. Union, the Lady Cougars, when they talk about this Cougar team, you know, one of the things they talk about is the short girl out there. You're going to see her here in a little bit. But she is just an animal on the defensive end. Now, you've got to get really crafty on how to get her some shots on offense, but Union's going to have to work hard on defense, and that's what they're used to doing, so I expect nothing different from them. So number five, Katie Ross, she is number five. She's going to be starting at point guard. Shayla Draper, number 14. Alyssa Berge, number 15. Paige Farnsworth is number 20, and Cassie Houston, number 33 for the Lady Cougars. And out of that starting lineup, there are all seniors. So basically consider this a senior night for the Lady Cougars. And I'll tell you what, why not? They probably already had their first senior night. Why not have another one tonight? This is the last time for sure that those girls will be playing on this floor. So an exciting night tonight, playoff basketball, 3A playoffs, a doubleheader tonight, starting with the Lady Cougars taking on the Panthers from Pineview, coming all the way up from St. George on a Friday night. And if you're in St. George watching our stream, thanks for joining us. Remember, you can always watch Lady Cougar action on VTVchannel6.com. Looks like they're going to be getting ready for the national anthem, so we're going to take a quick break. And guess what, Brandon? Game's going to start in just a moment.
All right, game on. Let's go.
So let's send it back to the trailer. We'll be back in just a moment.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Get out of the cold this winter and come to Affinity Sports Zone, where the fun comes naturally. We have arcade games, the lounge room, and batting and pitching cages. We offer a fully stocked snack bar and a bully-free environment where kids can come and have fun. We do parties in groups, or just bring your friends and come on down. Like Affinity Sports Zone on Facebook and come see us today.
Welcome back to Union High School, Roosevelt, Utah, as they prepare to give you the starting lineups for this important matchup in 3A classification. If you are a 1 or 2 seed in your region, you get to host a playoff game. And tonight for Roosevelt and for Union High School, they get lucky enough to host two. And both Roosevelt/Union teams are number one seeds. And that's a great accomplishment.
Yeah, I don't know how many times that happens, but that's a really cool feeling. And I remember being in the building on senior night a couple weeks ago. There's a lot of high energy, but it feels like there's the same type of energy today.
Yeah, it does. As they're introducing the lineups, let's once again go over the Panthers starting lineup. Number 3, Sarah Van Allen. Number 5, Sarah Pierce. Number 10, Claire Newby. Number 24, Tavia Akeen. And number 33, Brianna Moe. And it looks like they've got some pretty good size there. If I had to guess, that Sarah Pierce looks like she's a pretty tall girl. And they look like they've got some athletic girls over there on the Pineview side. They are going to be wearing black today, and Union being introduced in their white jerseys. The winner of this game will actually then go to, I believe, Cedar City, where they will take on the winner of the JUAB Morgan game going on right now at the same time. Maybe they're playing tomorrow, but this weekend they're playing to determine who is playing who. So as you see the introductions, number 5, Catherine Ross, a 5'6 guard senior, her last game on this floor. Number 14, Shayla Draper, 6-foot guard senior. And I remember watching her play quite a bit over the years. Alyssa Berge, and they introduce her, number 15. She's a senior guard at 5'6". You've got number 20, Paige Farnsworth, a senior forward at 5'9". And then last but not least, Cassie Houston wearing number 33, a senior center at 6 foot. And we'll see how well she matches up with the center from Pineview. All right, here we go. So Union and the Roosevelt team is going to be going from our left to our right on the television screen. They're in white. Pineview is in black. Now, have you been to many games here besides senior night? You mentioned that, Brandon.
Yeah, I went to senior night, and I broadcasted their game a couple weeks ago with Stansberry as well. And so definitely got to see the Union girls put on a show. They're a really good defensive team, and they get up and down the floor. Tori Ross, like you said, she's a firecracker.
Yeah.
Undersized, but she gets down and dirty with the team. So
they're going to give this first jump. I believe that goes to Pineview officially, even though it just goes out of bounds. So Pineview is going to inbound near the basket. They're going to score. Now, these people to our left, Brandon, they're called the Cougar Crazies. Be ready for them.
All right.
We actually had to move from one side of the gym to the other because the band in there are so loud sometimes. Knocked right out of bounds. The action we've seen in the first 4 seconds are two defensive plays by the Union Cougars as they knock two different passes / jump balls out of bounds. So Pineview to inbound a second time in a row. Underneath, they lost track of her. That's 2 points quick for Sarah Pierce.
Yeah, like you said, Brian, they have a lot of size down low, and you can see that there's quite a bit of athletic ability out there. So we'll see how Union matches up.
You know, the trait of a good team is how you adjust through that first half and halftime. Right there, a throwaway on the first possession for Union. So just 21 seconds into the quarter, and Union with a turnover in Pineview looking to beat this full court press. Man-to-man is what they have. And it's 5 seconds. Wow.
Oh.
I was wondering what was taking her so long. And the ref, I believe that was even more than 5 seconds because it seemed like that was forever. I was watching everybody move on the court. Where's the ball? So Union gets to inbound underneath the basket in which they want to score, and refs are stopping play. Every time there's a stoppage in play, we got to mention sponsors. L&L Motor, with the tent event savings going on now, receive up to $9,000 of any new heavy-duty truck on the lot. Biggest inventory of Ford and Ram, all under one roof. L&L Motor, for as long as I can remember, a sponsor of VTV Sports, covering the Union Cougars. Inbound pass in the key and thrown away again. Two turnovers for the Lady Cougars. And Pineview in a hurry down court and drawing a foul on the ground. Here are the Panthers.
Yeah, sometimes in tournament settings, you just get a little bit too excited and you want to get off to a good start, and so you get things in a hurry and turn the ball over. So we'll see.
And that was a great move trying to split right there. Oh, same exact play. Oh, boy, Union's got to find a way to stop that. They get everybody kind of going one way, and then someone squirts back on that backside block.
Yeah, even the same person with Sarah Pierce down there at number 5. She's got some good size, and she just put it right in there. She was wide open.
3-point shot. Good. Look at that.
Woo!
And listen to the crowd. I told you they're crazy, buddy. Full court press, but they back off a little bit this time. And intercepted down court and out of bounds, though, so it's going to be Pineview ball. But great hustle play.
Yeah, you definitely got to like the hustle. You got to like the three-pointer right there by Berge.
She was wide open. They worked that shot, and it probably feels so good for her to hit that first shot. Sometimes the hardest shots to hit, either the first or the last.
Especially if you get them early, you'll get your confidence early, and then it should be a great game.
Well, besides Union turning it over on offense twice, they have knocked that ball out of bounds at least 3 times. Now they got to keep an eye on Pierce and make sure she doesn't squirt behind. And now a drive in off the glass, rebounded by the same, and now she's going to the line, and that's Tavia Akeem. Can you believe we're just a minute 3 into this game? Boy, she did get hammered right there. No call, not necessarily hammered. It looked like a lot of contact, but here's where she gets fouled. Right there, it almost seemed like it was long before that shot even went up.
Yeah, she's definitely tall and athletic too. She is their leading scorer with 261 points this year.
200, wow. That just seems like a lot. Until you realize, who was it? Kim Olajuwon or somebody? No, not Olajuwon. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar scored probably 38,000.
And Mr. Alcindor with 38,000.
Yep. All right, Akeen with 2 points, 6-3. Pineview with the lead. Fakes the three this time, and they got her for the travel. They do that pump fake, and they take that first or second step before they get that ball on the ground. If you establish that pivot, say, on your left foot, and then you lift up that left foot before you get the ball down, they're going to call a travel.
You see that in high school, and they see that in college. You see it all the time that they just get just too fast with that first step. They just got to take a step first.
Oh, look at this. Dribble free ball and hustling down court, but oh, it is a backcourt because she touched it first.
Yeah.
So a smart play, but I mean, a great hustle by the Cougar there, but a smart play by Akeen as well.
Yeah, Cassie Houston, she just got in the middle of that play. And that's what she does. She takes offensive fouls. She gets in the middle of things. That's what I've seen from her.
Minute 25. That's all that has expired this first quarter. A lot of whistles. There it goes. Baseline drive. Ooh, she looked a little off balance. If she was on balance, she may have taken that the whole way. Throw away again, but tapped out. Oh,
ooh.
I'm not sure who that went off of, but they give it to Pineview.
Definitely looked like it went off 24.
Yeah, it did.
Off Aquin.
Well, Pineview ball and knocked out of bounds. See, this is why the clock's taking forever. It's because Union's getting a hand in there and knocking out of bounds. That's got to be the fifth or sixth deflection out of bounds already in a minute 41. And that's a sign of an active defense. But they do have two team fouls, too, so they got to be careful. Three-point shot. She just steps back, and oof, she looks like she's been there before. It's going to stay Pineview, though. Yeah, it is. That's a good call. That time it was off Union on the rebound. Inbounding. It looks like they've figured out that little inbound play that Pineview scored twice on. Oh, look at that.
Good steal.
Yeah. Very active defense. Inside on the block. Oh, off her knee. She does save it. Ross inside, off balance, underneath, blocked. Rebound, Pineview. As much as went right for the Cougars there, it went wrong, especially with a fast break bucket right there. And they need a timeout. They did a lot of, I mean, they did a lot of good down here moving that ball, and when things went wrong, they found a person to pass it to and bail them out, but that block just led straight to that fast break.
That was definitely unfortunate, but you, like you said, they're getting their hands on the ball. They're being aggressive, and yeah, I think if they just keep doing that, that they, you know, they won't have any problems.
So Pineview up 8-3 over the Lady Cougars, and right now is the best time to join Strata Networks and get the most reliable coverage in the basin. Going on at Strata right now, you can get $300 back when you switch to Strata's wireless service, and at the same time, customers can buy select smartphones and get a second one absolutely free. Strata Networks, a great sponsor of VTV Sports and the Union Cougars. All right, so a quick 30-second timeout, and Ross is back in action with the ball. Inside, crowded paint, Union on the floor, saves it. And, you know, I got to give credit to the Pineview defense. They're creating this uncertainty from the Union Cougar offense.
Yeah, Queen, she's getting into that play just like she's done with scoring on the other side. She's definitely a good defender as well.
You know, already, if I had to pick someone I'd want on my team, I think Shayla Draper, just watching her hustle right now, she's definitely Ross. Oh, that's a smart play. Oh my goodness. Sometimes I'm just amazed at just how much these high school kids know basketball and can think that quickly on the floor. Elbow to the corner, and that's Draper. Got two high posts and two wings. Now the high post switch, trying to create a little bit of a mix-up, and now a throwaway. So another turnover, Union.
Turnover. Just got a good look where you're going for the ball first and then throw it to the person you want. But that was a good play. Good hustle. And like I said, they're getting on the floor. They're getting their hands in. It's what you want to see.
So we're 3 minutes in, first quarter, and tumbling on the ground, no call. But in the lane, Pineview scores. Oh, boy, look at that. Claire Newby getting on the board. That's four separate Pineview Panthers who've scored this quarter already. Draper, left elbow. Ooh. We both had this same reaction, just off the back of the rim. You know that that's a tough shot. The elbow's got to be one of those tough ones because, you know, when you shoot threes, you can put a little bit of muscle behind it as they work underneath. Look at that. Clear, wide open shot from 16, no good. Rebound, Union. An elbow shot you have to have touch on it, more so than most any shot out there. All the way across, there it goes, and up top they reset. So 4:15, first quarter. Ross working it. Down seven are the Lady Cougars early. Draper inside, post, up, off the glass. Look at that.
Yeah, Houston works her body in there and gets really aggressive and puts it in for two right there. That's a great play.
So give the assist to Draper and the bucket to Cassie Houston. And Draper, look at her, stealing it. She's already outrun the defense. Makes a nice move right there off the glass.
Wow.
Good. And listen to that crowd.
What a good adjustment by the coach right there to double team a queen. She's been absolutely killing it. And so they put a double team on her and got her in trouble. Look at them all over the floor right there.
Yep. Timeout for Blindview. Yep. Oh, look, this is what I'm sure Roosevelt wanted to do, was be physical on defense. And when you see a girl on the ground like that, you know that it's physical out there. Yeah. And twice in a row, Draper coming up with a steal and a near steal right there.
Plus with the extra motivation of this being a region game, a one and done, I mean, they're gonna fight to the end.
And you can hear when the baskets are made, boy, this place just is electric for about 3 to 4 seconds, just cheering on these girls. The girls usually don't play in front of as many people that are here tonight. And with this doubleheader boys-girls matchup, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of folks here. Ashley Regional Medical Center is the home of the Basin's best orthopedic care. If you have broken bones, sprains, or strains, or if you have a knee or hip pain, call our orthopedic specialists. You can also go on their website at ashleyregional.com to take advantage of the tools and information you will find there. See a list of all the available physicians and specialties. Get information on the medication you're taking or read about the services offered at Ashley Regional, ashleyregional.com. Look at that. Just thrown right away. Defensive effort.
Just really got to like the defensive effort of Union out there right now. Offensively, Pineview is doing better, but if they play the defense that they're playing right now, that they're going to get right back into this game. And I think that's what the coach, exactly what Garrett told them.
So Ross, and on the right side is number 24, Chesney Nielsen. Look at that drive from Draper off the glass, but the rebound, even better. Up,
what a great rebound. Oh, my.
Count it. It's good.
Gets the and one shot.
Boy, when you can drive in and get defenders off you, you clear out the rebounding lanes, and then your rebounder puts it up strong, gets a little friendly roll, and now it can be a tie game, and it is. A tie game, 10-10, 7-0 Union Cougar run. What a great play. Already the play of the first quarter right there from Paige Farnsworth. So I mentioned there were four Pineview Panthers. Nice rebound there from the Panthers as well. A little bit over the back, you could argue, but not that time. That one's up and good by Sarah Pierce. She's got 6 points. I mentioned earlier the Pineviews had four girls on the board, led by Sarah Pierce with six, but the Cougars have four as well. So scoring for both teams, well-rounded, and nobody's in the corner, and that's thrown away. Another turnover.
Yeah, you said the height is going to be a little bit of trouble from this Pineview team, and you can kind of see that. But all they have to do down there is just block out a little bit better, and they can get those rebounds. But they're doing a pretty good job of having, like you said, 4 and 4 rebounds. So
2:40 first quarter, and it's all the way down in the middle. That's not where you want to let the ball go. And that's easy 2 points from Brianna Moe, I think. I don't know how to say her last name.
That's our fourth point of the game, and they've been wide open. A lot of these shots that Pineview has been getting have been wide open.
Boy, you get that momentum on a 7-0 run, and then back it comes with Pineview. Now, they did miss what seemed like a pretty easy layup there. A nice pass down court. Even better reception and traffic and a travel right there. That's a good call.
Definitely a good call on the travel.
But it seems like you get that excitement on the 7-0 run, and then you turn the ball over. You're just not getting that middle clogged or whatever well enough. A little let down, a 4-0 run from Pineview right there.
Right, and I don't know if it would have been better just to pass that ball back out and get their offensive going.
Both teams with two team fouls, so, you know, she took it in, probably looking to also draw a foul, get to the line. Boy, they know what they're doing on breaking that press. Watch film for the Union Cougar, or the Lady Cougars. able to break that press. Look at that in the corner, wide open. The pass took a while to get there. It wasn't a great pass. Didn't set up for a shot, but this one does. Look at that, 3-point shot. And that's the girl you said was a 3-point artist.
Yeah, Stephanie Gleave with 43 threes on the year, and that's 44. Pretty much a 3-point specialist there.
Oh, trying to match
it. Answer.
Yep. Rebound, Pineview, minute and a half, first quarter. 17-10, so after a 7-0 run, you give up a 7-0 run.
You can see Gleave wide open in the corner, and that's what she's trying to get, that shot.
Wild shot, good no call. And Draper through the middle, up, off the glass, no good. She was trying to draw a foul right there with a little float or two. And Pineview comes away from it. Another girl on the floor for Pineview. But she gets up. That's number 10, Claire Newby. Right corner. You got to get down there quick. Emma Evans. She's out there. She's kind of on the wing. The shortest Cougar out there, even shorter than Ross.
Yeah, you can see Pineview, they know they're in control, so they can kind of just work the ball around and get a good shot, and so that's what they're doing.
Yep, that's 6 points in the last minute for her, and it's a 10-0 run, 20-10 in favor of Pineview.
Like to see a timeout here by Union.
High post, right side, fake the three. Off a knee. Oh, she saves it right to Pineview. 14 seconds.
Good hustle play, but just unfortunate she couldn't get it to her teammate there.
And 8-7. And a wild shot, but look who's got the rebound. She's going to get it back out. 2-1 at the buzzer. It goes in.
Good. She made it.
And that was number 5, Sarah Pierce, with 8 points that quarter. That was a long quarter. Let's take a minute break. We'll be back with the second quarter. 22-10, it's VTV.
Given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services, including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high-quality service to their customers now and in the future.
Pineview up 22-10 over the Lady Cougars, a 4 seed coming from the St. George region in 3A basketball. In fact, twice tonight we're going to see number 4s take on number 1s as the Union Cougars host St. George teams on both sides. So kind of a disappointing end to that first quarter. Guys, it was 10-10, about, what, 2.5 minutes left?
Yes.
And a 12-0 run just went crazy. Look at that back cut.
What a great play.
Shayla Draper from Ross. Draper's got 4 points, 22-12. And Pineview not wasting any time, but those fast break shots are a little out of control, but you got to get the rebounds.
Yeah, Katie Ross is going to be a leader on this team, and she's going to make things happen down there. And she got a wide open assist right there. Tori Ross has the ball right now. She's doing really good as well.
Boy, you see some physical play off the ball. I love it. I love it. One of the things as a girls' basketball coach, it's hard to teach is when they're young, is to be physical as Pineview blocks that one out of bounds.
Yeah, and I'm not sure if the Pineview players like that physicality. Me and Brian were watching them on the bench, and they were kind of wheezing over and kind of holding their arms a little bit. I don't know if they've seen this kind of physical play, so we'll see how they handle it.
So Ross at the line. And the first one is no good. But what I'm talking about early on, and here's, I guess she did get fouled on this block coming from behind. Oh, yeah, you can see on the left hand right there, there's a little bit more than ball. So second free throw up and good after it hits everything. Finally goes down. 7:15, second quarter. It's 24-13, an 11-point game. Look at this. They just use that cut and drive to the basket right away. Now, that number 10, who's Claire Newby for Pineview, does not always look completely in control when she drives in. She's a great ball handler. She's taken these screens the right way, but she's been short or long on all of her layups.
You had a bunch of sharks on that play. You had three people going in to get the ball and getting it to knock off that Aquin's foot. And so now they have another possession. Great defense. Oh, what a great pass by Troy Ross. Oh, but just couldn't get it in.
They waited for that one to fall off the rim before they called the foul. But going to the free throw line is Chesney Nielsen. Let's see. Look at that. I mean, that's twice already. She just goes off. A little body after the ball's let go. But the guy who actually called it, all he could see as the free throw is good, all he could see was Pineview and the Union girl and on the other side of her. So if you think about his angle.
How about the vision of Tori Ross, though, getting that pass in?
Yeah, that's a team that's played together for a long time.
And she's just a freshman. So there's a lot that she can do still. And she's just learning that at such a young age. That's a great look.
One is good out of two. That's the second time to the line that the Lady Cougars have hit one for two. So 24-14. And Newby, watch her try to take the screen. She's a driver. Of course, she'll clear it out for a minute and try to create something else. Inside, now she's got it. Oh, she missed it. The other direction, Lady Cougars, and on the block, a foul right there. That's a good call. That's number 21, Rachel Lusk on the foul. You know, we'll see the replay right here, but even in live action, you can see that she came right across the arms, right? Maybe the right hand, but it was hard. And when you swipe that hard and something happens, the refs are going to call it. I think that's still a good call anyway. And, going to the line again for the Lady Cougars is Paige Farnsworth. She had the and one earlier, so she's one for one from the line. Watch this. Nice inbound pass. And then down low and on the arms and the body and everything.
Just another great pass by Tori. And then the play before when Tori came down, she, you know, usually a freshman will try to take it and go in the lane and do it themselves. But she knew she had a friend right there, and she just passed it right back to her.
We'll keep it here. It's just a 30-second timeout. We'd like to thank our sponsors, Moon Lake Electric, in operation since 1938, owned by the people they serve. Moon Lake is a cooperative. They're not privately owned. And they've been providing the power to the area since 1938. Find them and like them on Facebook. Also, in just a little bit, we're going to have the Ridgeline Motorsports halftime show. The halftime coverage is brought to you by Ridgeline Motorsports. We'll have replays and we'll break down the first half, what they can do the second half. Ridgeline Motorsports, work hard, play harder. All right, here we go. Free throw line. And at the line is Paige Farnsworth, 3 points. I like how they're attacking the basket. Pineview seems like they want to get physical back, but the foul count is racked up on them. The Cougars are in bonus the rest of the way.
Wow. Well, they definitely turn on the intensity and try to get it inside. Plus, their defense has just been killer on the other side.
Paige Farnsworth, a senior at 5'9", and she is now 3 for 3 from the line. Wow. So it is 24-16.
So important that you get free throws that go, especially in tournament play. And both teams are doing really well with that.
Into the corner. And it's a 2-3 zone, but in order for that 2-3 zone to be, actually, it looks like a 3-2. One of those rotating 3-2, 2-3s it doesn't matter where you start, you're going to end up guarding somebody down low eventually. And that was a definite size advantage for Akeen, hitting her 6 points right there. Draper for three, other side, no good, rebound, and Pineview's got it. And here's Akeen again, and that's too easy.
That's Tavla Akeen again, leading scorer for their team, leading do everything for this team actually all year.
5.5 minutes, second quarter, and it's 28-16. Right side, Ross fakes the three, gets it tapped away. Draper's got to save that, and she does, but to the wrong person. Back in time is the defense. Look at that shot out of bounds.
Block.
Look at that. She was not fooled by a little spin move. And you know, the replay is brought to you by L&L Motor, if we have that one. 28-16, Pineview to inbound underneath. Oh, underneath. Oh, look at the block and the foul right there. They're trying again to get it to Sarah. What is it, Pierce? And she's going to go to the line. She's got 8 points already. Nice block from behind, but usually there's a lot of body in that situation. She had great position underneath. And the first one's off.
Yeah, Union needs to do just a little bit better job of getting those people out of the paint. They're getting it way too deep, and it's just too easy to put it in right there.
Here's the replay. You can see how they set that screen to get her position. She's got position, so if you block it, you're probably going to get called for the foul. And it is a good foul because, look, she missed both.
Wow.
Ross with a crossover, left side Draper. Inside the paint, she loses it, and it's saved by a fellow Lady Cougar. 5 minute mark, second quarter, 12 point game. That's where it was at the start of the quarter. Ross with a spin, jump from, and look at the soft touch.
Oh, wow, it's good. Katie Ross with a great jump shot right there from the free throw line.
That had enough arc. I was just thinking, you know what, that's going to hit high off the rim. Whoa, that's a great move. And over the back, anybody?
Should have been an over back call, but they didn't get it, put it in.
Yep, 10 points there now for Sarah Pierce, 30-18. It seems like when the Cougars score, Pineview wastes no time scoring right back. It's an even second quarter so far, but it's turning out to be a pretty high scoring game. Left side on the block, leaving them fight for position. Now switching, 3 point attempt. Ooh. No good, rebound though. Off the glass and good. Paige Farnsworth, 7 points.
Really good rebound there by Paige Farnsworth. She doesn't want her team to go home.
30-20. So 4 minutes, halfway through the second quarter. I tell you, I like the way this girl handles the ball right here. She's looking for something. She clears right, but I'm guessing she's going to get it right back. There it is.
Again, Pineview just slowing the ball down a little bit. Now they know they're in control.
Oh my goodness. Where I was criticizing her earlier for a little too hard or not getting it up above the rim, she makes a great play right there. That's the play of the second quarter so far. Sorry to interrupt you.
No, you're fine.
I was just watching that move. That's a great move. Now Draper responds. Good! 32-23. That's a big shot. And you know what? You know who had the perfect view of that shot? Me. I was like, that is online.
You know shooters are going to get it going, and that's what happened there.
Oh,
Tori Ross with a big steal. She's on her way.
Trying to get that to the high post and two. No,
oh, it's just a little too hard, but she gets fouled on the other side.
So shooting free throws is the big hustler. I'll tell you what, since she's, I don't know, about 6 minutes through the first quarter, Paige Farnsworth just has come up big. So for the last about 7 minutes of game time. Oh, I just marked her with 2 points. That's not good. She's at the free throw line, Brian. So she's got 7 points, now eight. She's perfect from the line.
Yeah, she's been that spark to come off the bench and to really make a contribution here. And to be perfect from the free throw line. That's big.
Yep. She's just been there for every rebound. If you are a selfless enough player to let someone else take that first shot, but get in great position to get a second shot, that's how you can get a lot of points. But it takes a lot of hard work, and she's perfect still. 9 points, Paige Farnsworth, and she comes out. In for her is Reagan Anderson, giving her a break.
She's been one of the leading rebounders this whole year. She has 89, so that's... She's a hustler. She can rebound. She's a do-everything kind of girl.
And knocked
defense
around.
Defense right there by Houston.
Ross, right side. She hit a three-pointer to begin this game, but she drives in this time. Oof. Misses. That was Elisa Berge, but Pineview's across midcourt up top. Oh, they'll let her shoot, but you don't want to leave her open. The foul. Oh, they're lucky that went out. The foul's going to be on Ross. It's a 7-point game. 2.5 minutes or so in the second quarter left. Yeah, wide open. What can he do here except for just make, well, a little body foul, not much else. And that just rolls right out of there. Free throw good. And that's for Kenya Schoen, a senior. She looks about, I don't know, is she about 6 foot-ish?
6 foot, yeah. There's about four of those on that team.
Yeah. Some teams just have a height, man.
There must be something in the water in that St. George area, you know?
Yeah, they keep building high schools like crazy. Last I checked, they didn't have much water down there. Missed shot. Looks like it may have been partially blocked. Coming back the other way is probably going to be 34-25. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't do that. Ooh. Okay, off. She finally missed one. She's 2 for 3. Oh, that could have been a travel. She hopped around before getting that contact. She made a great rebound, but I swear she moved that foot before she started pivoting.
Yeah, the refs call a jump ball there, and the possession goes to Pineview.
So 34-25, a 9-point game.
See what kind of play they have drawn up here out of an out-of-bounds play.
Same thing, picked off this time, though. Oh, that's just mean right there. No call, but you know what? They get it away. Anderson is now plowed over. I'll tell you what, she's going to the free throw line. Anderson just got into the game. Look at this. I mean, when you got 6 foot on 5 foot two, and then this time is the exact same thing, two different girls, and you saw her left ankle there. It looked like it got turned. She got up limping a little bit, so let's keep an eye on that.
Yeah, first kind of looked like a dirty play, but then when I saw it in the replay, it looked like she was going for the ball, and it just kind of hit her going out. So it was a foul, just common foul.
Reagan Anderson, a freshman.
Missed everything on the free throw.
Yeah. She's a freshman, but she's 6 foot out there. Oh, boy, she's going to have three more good years on this team. Look who's running the point. They don't have, I forgot number 10's name for a second. They don't have her out there, so they're trying to use some of the... Oh, boy, look at that, trying to get contact, and she gets bailed out. I'll tell you what, you could see she looked like a running back trying to go through those little running back, you know, those arms that trying to knock the ball out, the machine. Watch her right here. She goes, boom, and she just, I mean, I guess technically that is a foul, but.
Yeah, she tries to go through the gauntlet, like you said, like a football play there.
Yeah, thank you, gauntlet. That's kind of the word I was looking for. She misses the first one. This is Sarah Van Allen. And, you know, actually, as a coach, I'd probably be proud of that because she was going in for the contact and she got it. So
I appreciate those football plays. I'm a football guy.
I just can't remember the names of anything, so I'll always try to describe something. And yeah, that's what you can do. You can be the dictionary. I'll give you the definition. You give me the word.
All right, you bet. I'm here for you.
All right, Sarah Van Allen, 1 for 2. She's got 1 point. And a minute 39 and counting, 10-point game, 35-25. They got it. They got dig into this, get to single digits before the half. I mean, it's only 1 point away, but you can't be doing that. Got to make good passes, make sure they're open. Now, look, Ross looks short, but then you see right next to her, a 5 foot Tori Ross, the younger one. Oh, I think I called her Emma Evans earlier. I'm sorry, I was on the wrong roster. Both Ross girls out there.
Yeah, Tori Ross, she's a firecracker.
One to the other and off the back of the iron, and the Cougars got to hustle back on D. That's a great pass. Look at that.
Oh, but she just couldn't convert on it. And but she gets her own rebound and gets fouled.
Now she gets hammered, yeah. Boy, 35-25. Like I said, they need single digits to go in the half.
Well, at Union, you do everything right. You make her miss the layup, but then you just don't rebound the ball. But, you know, Pineview, she did a good job there to get her
own
rebound.
Here she gets the rebound. Oh, yeah, she totally got undercut. How many fouls does Ross have? Just one for the Cougars? I wonder. They gave that to 23.
That's just one foul.
As the first one's good by Moe. Yeah, they gave that to little Ross.
By how physical this game has been, you'd think there would be three or four fouls on someone. But there's only one or two.
And the second one's good. So 6 points, 37-25, 6 points for that shooter. Moe Anderson out, the freshman, and back in, getting a quick rest is the spark plug for the Lady Cougars, Paige Farnsworth. All the way left side. Look at that nice little crossover. Juke from 6 feet rolls in.
Good shot by Bergie. little in the lane floater right there.
I love that play.
Oh, and a good steal right there.
Nice pass. That's the Cougar play of the half right there. It's Berge again, but even better was that pass. The arc on the pass, the ability for your receiver to run under that pass. Here's my driver again, and off the front of the rim. Rebound, Pineview. There's the three-point shooter. So we've got the driver, the three-point shooter. And with 22 seconds left, guess what? It's an eight-point game. Uh-oh. Oh, she held back. She held back. Free throw line, shot. No good, rebound, and no good. Rebound, and good. Darn it, you don't give her three chances on that. Natasha Fiamni with 5 seconds left gets that shot to go, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pineview Panthers have scored. Ross in the paint, up with the no foul. She went to draw the foul, but maybe she focused too much on that as she kind of leaped forward almost like a Superman jump. I think if she would have still gone with her normal flip shot, she would have gotten more of a call there.
Yeah, and on the other side there, they had three offensive rebounds right there in a row where Union didn't block out. Again, that's what they've been having trouble with, and I'm pretty sure their coach is going to be telling them, block out, block out.
Well, a long first half, but we've got 10 minutes until the next half, the third quarter, so team's talking about it. We'll talk about it as well, but first let's take a break. We've got the Ridgeline Motorsports halftime show in just a moment.
These days, we all want more speed, and right now at Strata Networks, that's exactly what you're going to get. For a limited time, upgrade your current internet package and get faster speeds at no additional cost for 90 days. That's right. Browse, stream, and download faster with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. Call us today to get your free speed boost, only from Strata Networks. Restrictions apply. See store for details. Strata Networks. We connect lives.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know. People who care.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In three consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only one was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a one-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
Pilot Thomas Logistics provides a wide variety of services including fuel delivery, lubes, and oils. Pilot Thomas has experienced tremendous growth in the last couple of years with the merging of Western Petroleum and Thomas Petroleum. They have local employees that are committed to providing their customers with excellent service and competitive pricing, while having some unique services like a DEF pump dispenser at the Naples Card Lock. As Pilot Thomas continues to be a leader in the fuel distribution industry, they are committed to providing high quality service to their customers now and in the future.
You're watching the Ridgeline Motorsports Halftime Report
on VTV6.
at Union High School, Brian Baldwin, Brandon Jones at halftime of the 3A first round game between number one Union Cougars and the number four of their region down south, the Pineview Panthers. And the score at the half, Pineview over the Union Cougars, 39-29. This halftime show is brought to you by Ridgeline Motorsports. Ridgeline Motorsports has significant rebates going on now on all 2014 and 2015 Ski-Doo snowmobiles and 2015 Can-Am side-by-side and four-wheelers with rebates up to $2,500. Come check out all the new Can-Am Workhorse Extreme Utility Defender, towing capacity of 2,000 pounds and a payload capacity of 1,500 pounds, a new Versa Pro 3-person bench seat with adjustable driver seat. Every Can-Am ATV and side-by-side vehicle is built with the same DNA. Industry-leading performance, precision-engineered handling, and a rider-focused design. Get ready to ride with the new Can-Am off-road vehicle at Ridgeline Motorsports today. Can-Am, the ride says it all. Go see the friendly staff at Ridgeline Motorsports at 543 East Main in Vernal, or call 789-RIDE. Ridgeline Motorsports, work hard, play harder. All right, we've got 5 minutes until the second half starts. And Brandon, one thing that I was just thinking about, the Lady Cougars need to take care of the ball.
Yeah, definitely need to take care of the ball. And then, like I said, they need to block out as well. They need to get rebounds underneath. Well,
and part of that is Pineview taking that ball and running the first opportunity they get. And they're starting to hit those layups now. They're going to switch directions. That really doesn't matter much. But I'll tell you what, the Cougars are playing good defense, but they are undersized, as you said. They need to box out and get that good position.
Yeah, there's three or four girls on that other team that have 6 foot. You know, they're in there in the lane. They know the weakness of the Union Cougars, and they're putting it to them. It's really only a 10-point game right now, though, so Union can definitely come back with this. They can get a little bit more intense on their defense and get more inside shots like they have been doing a little bit.
Yeah, let's see how they got here to 39-29. Let's take a look at the highlights. And the one thing I loved after going down 4-0 was Berge getting in the corner. This wide open three for the first points for Union. Then Newby with a two-point shot. That's a good shot from her. She's a great driver. Houston with 2 points in here. And this was not easy, but she got it up there. She kept the ball high. Draper, fast break, layup as she's been hustling all night. Pierce with 2 points here off a rebound. That's the height you're talking about. Stephanie Gleave, a three, and she hit one shortly after that as well. Draper, back cut to start the second quarter. Beautiful play. A layup for Pineview, and this is the one where I said that's the play of the second quarter because she came up and under, and then a Draper three there later in the second quarter. I'll tell you what, there's a couple players that I take on my team, and I've already told you that I would take Shayla Draper, but that Claire Newby for Pineview, I like the way that she handles the ball. I like her aggressiveness, taking it inside. And when they give her the opportunity, she takes it. So Union's got to close that down. They've got to close down the passing lanes. My question is, Brandon, can Union play with six players out there?
I think they can, and then they have also had
I mean, they can't, but you think that's what they would need, or they just need to run around like crazy.
Yeah. And then, you know, you got also Paige Farnsworth, who's came off, and she's done really well. Really good job of getting in the paint and getting her hands on the ball and also putting the ball back in the hoop when our team needs it. So you definitely can't play with six people out there, but you know, you can increase the gap by putting better players out there.
Wave to the camera right there. Hey guys, we're up here. We're on the we're kind of angled right a little bit on the floor, but we've got a great view of the whole floor from up here. Thanks for joining us here on VTV, where you can always go to VTVchannel6.com to check out past games and live streams of current games. Remember, there's one right after this too, where the boys is the number one seed in their region, take on the number four seed from the Spanish Fork region again, but this time it's Snow Canyon in the boys game. So the girls tonight, a 1-4 game, and you think looking at it that, you know, the number one is definitely going to be the number four, but you know what? That's why you play interregion. That's why you mix up the regions a little bit. When they finally get to the arena down in southern Utah, you know what? It's going to be the eight best teams down there.
Yeah, you definitely want to see the best talent, and that's what you have here. And even though that they're, would you say they were fourth in their region, they look like a really good team, and they're here to play.
Yep, St. George, they always produce tough teams, and once they leave this arena tonight, they get to go play down there in Cedar City, so it's almost going to be like home for them. So the Union Cougars definitely got to take advantage of this opportunity tonight. And, you know, it was really encouraging when they went on a 7-0 run to tie the game at 10. But what did they do right after that? They gave up 12 straight. That's got to stop.
Yeah, definitely. And that comes on from not rebounding and them just getting second shots and third shots even. So look for them to get more rebounding and more aggressive.
All right, let's take a quick one-minute break. We'll be back with the third quarter right after this. It's VTV in a 10-point game.
Get out of the cold this winter and come to Affinity Sports Zone, where the fun comes naturally. We have arcade games, the lounge room, and batting and pitching cages. We offer a fully stocked snack bar and a bully-free environment where kids can come and have fun. We do parties in groups, or just bring your friends and come on down. Like Affinity Sports Zone on Facebook and come see us today.
Just about to start the third quarter here at Union High School. The Lady Cougars in white hosting the Panthers from Pineview, and it's going to start as Panthers ball in this third quarter. And on the floor for the Panthers, it looks like their starting lineup. You've got Sarah Van Allen, Sarah Pierce, Claire Newby, Tavia Akeen, and Brianna Moe for the Lady Cougars. You've got Catherine Ross with the ball, and she just double dribbled right there as she tried to get it to Draper. You've also got Bergie out there, Paige Farnsworth, number 20, and Cassie Houston, number 23. They're all seniors. So 10-point game. So the Panthers, did I say the Panthers got the ball? It looked like it was actually the Lady Cougars. I'm sorry. So when they switch directions, it confuses me. So the Panthers get that ball out of bounds and knocked out by Union, so they're going to inbound underneath. You got to correct me on that, man.
Sorry. I just didn't want to tell you you're wrong.
I can take it. I really can. Oh, three-point shot from up top. That's not a way the Union Cougars want them to start, unless it's like that where they air ball. I'll tell you what, if that would have gone in, that would have been a tough shot to start the quarter with.
Yeah, that wasn't Stephanie Glebe shooting from three out there, and so she didn't hit very well on that one.
Yep.
But I think she can shoot the ball.
Moe there?
Yeah.
Yeah, sometimes they don't take enough shots after the half. Their body kind of calms down for a moment. They got to get back into game speed. Look at that drive. And up and good. I like that right there. Number 15, Elisa Berge. And she scored the first points in each half.
And that's what Union needs to do. They need to go and start passing the ball around, getting their offense, and getting inside.
Look at that. They fronted Akeen there, so if the pass was going to get to her, it had to get over. She almost got her hand on it, but Draper knocked it out of bounds.
Yeah, if they didn't know about Akeen before, they do now, and that's probably one of their big focuses right now. They're going to double-team her until the end.
And they try a similar inbound pass with almost no intensity on that. Pineview comes out almost like they're just kind of walking through the motions. I don't see a whole lot of adrenaline from that. Look at that lazy pass. Shayla Draper picks it off. And Union's the one on the floor. And they're going to call Shayla Draper for a foul because she just went in there kind of diving for a football. And you still got to respect people's space in basketball. Watch her just kind of dive in with her shoulder. Right. She gets up and she just dives in right there. Oh, that shoulder almost to the chin.
Yeah, Pineview just looks a little bit lackadaisical, like you said, and they're just settling. They're settling for three-point shots that they don't really need. So,
well, that's two air balls from the same girl this half. So, you hear the Cougar crazies giving her some beef. 39-31. It's an 8-point game with those 2 points from Melissa earlier. And now they're trying to get it down low. And Pineview's doing the same thing, kind of fronting the post player, at least at first. Ross penetrating, trying to get it across. But once again, Pineview's between her and the ball. Nice screen. Ross is cleared. 3-point shot long. And I still just watching this. I know they got the rebound, but I'm just sitting here thinking Pineview's just kind of walking through the motions. But you know I like this right here.
Oof. Trying to get a floater in the lane, just couldn't quite get it to go. But look at all the bodies on the floor.
That was a floater that didn't go, and then a rebound by Brianna Moe gets, well, I don't know who it was, but it gets slapped away by Cassie Houston.
Did they actually call a foul?
I'm not sure. Yeah, they did.
They did. They called a foul in Houston.
Yeah, she, once again, the same thing as they got Draper for, that just kind of diving on the pile. Nice inlet pass, and I don't know how long she was in the key, but Sarah Pierce is going to the free throw line. Look at her. She's just kind of sitting there. She's sitting there. I don't know how many seconds she was there. That may have been 3 seconds. But she gets blocked from behind, and Houston, two fouls in about 13 seconds.
Yeah, two quick fouls there. Kind of what happens when things get a little bit physical inside, but she's got to watch that.
Well, if you're going to put someone on the free throw line, you want to put this girl. She's 0 for 3. 0 for 3 tonight. And they're 0 for 4. But a rebound to the wrong girl off the sideboard and stepping in front, getting that rebound. And now a foul is going to be called on Brianna Moe. I thought she stepped out of bounds, but Alyssa Berge comes away with that rebound.
I think that's like her fifth offensive rebound almost, trying to get that ball. She just doesn't give up. She puts it in, misses, and it gets it back.
All right, so no pressure. We're about 2 minutes into this third quarter. And Ross across midcourt, and here's that, you know, 3-2-2-3 kind of rotating defense. I just think of it kind of like a star. And they're definitely getting in those passing lanes as they knock it out of bounds there. You see this a lot in high school where they just kind of hover together and almost like a pentagon or a star. And then the one nearest you is who you got. And you'll transfer, you know, defensive assignments pretty quick. Block right there, return, and the only one back is Ross. And she keeps her pivot. I actually think that's a perfectly legal play because that left foot did not move once she planted it. Roosevelt down in a hurry. It's a 10-point game again, and now it's stolen away again. This is where they got to take care of that ball.
Yeah, back to a 10-point game. Got to like the handles number 10 out there. She can really handle that ball.
She's not scared to drive. I haven't seen her shoot from outside yet. Look at that position and missing.
Just, again, getting way too deep in the post. Union's got to not let that happen.
And Draper.
Oh.
And she hit the ground. She comes up right where that rebounder's twisting around, trying to get an elbow to the face. So 4:45, third quarter or so, a 10-point game, 41-33. Now, that first game, or the first half, was very high scoring. This one, not so much. That's a travel,
it's
if anything.
Travel.
Yes, they do get the travel.
Kalen Parsons on here on the inbound here. He has the travel. It's a good call.
Watch this. She plants her feet, then she moves, and then she gets the contact right there. She plants, but then she moves both her feet and travels right there before that contact. That's a great call. We couldn't quite see her feet in that shot, but just watching it live, that was the first instinct I had right there. Yeah. Four and a half, third quarter. So. Oh, position. Up off the glass. That's what you need.
There's Farnsworth again making big plays for her team in this first half.
8-point game. Time to chip down. Past eight. But you got to guard number 10. She didn't get a call right there. Now look at Akeem. She's getting this foul. This is a hustle foul for Union. I mean, it's going against Pineview because Union's hustling.
That's a big foul. That's three fouls on Akeem, their best player on their team. So she'll be done for the half. You won't see her till probably the
fourth quarter.
Fourth quarter.
Let's see. We got a timeout on the floor, and it is full. Let's take it. 41-33, Pineview over the Cougars, but the Cougars are slowly chipping away. We'll be right back.
Given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
These days, we all want more speed. And right now at Strata Networks, that's exactly what you're going to get. For a limited time, upgrade your current internet package and get faster speeds at no additional cost for 90 days. That's right. Browse, stream, and download faster with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. Call us today to get your free speed boost, only from Strata Networks. Restrictions apply. See store for details. Strata Networks. We connect lives.
Welcome back to Roosevelt. The Lady Cougars not putting a whole lot of points on the board, but they're not letting the Panthers do it either. 41-33, an eight-point game, 4:08, third quarter. Brian Baldwin, Brandon Jones, thanks for joining us wherever you are watching this first round 3A Lady basketball game. That's a nice pass, but it's going to be 3 seconds unless she gets it off right then, which she does. And Alyssa Berge, I'm sorry. Paige Farnsworth has come up so big tonight. Watch her just get this position, dribble back up, and get it off at the last moment she could have. I know they were about to call that 3 seconds. Now this is her second and one of the game.
13 points leading all scores. And 14.
And still perfect from the line.
How big is that?
Wow. So 3:55, third quarter is just a five-point game with that. And here comes Newby.
A little pressure defense here by Union trying to get the ball back.
It's a flip shot. That's not a bad idea, but
she's out of bounds.
Oh, that,
right there.
They didn't even catch that, yeah. Oh, nice. Look at that. Just a nice strip. Baloney. That's two bad calls. The first is a no call with that foot on the line, and the second one.
Right off the foot.
Yeah, right off the foot of Newby. Oh, my goodness. That was off the foot of Pineview. Two bad calls. If they score right here, I'm not going to be happy.
Unfortunate there, but.
You know what you could do? You can always rely on Paige Farnsworth. I'm sold on her. I want her on my team, too.
And Union, they're not going to complain about the calls. They're just going to go out there and play, and that's exactly what just happened, and they got the ball, and they got it back.
Well, they don't even know about this foot on the line. that's far away. That's the farthest part of the court away from the coaches. But that off the foot, boy, they missed that one. And an air ball, but look at who's there. Oh, no
Paige
call.
Falls with a no call, though.
Time to call a play.
36-41. We still have a close game now.
Yes.
Turned it over, and she has a wide open number.
Anderson. That's Anderson. A freshman. That's got to feel good for the freshman to get 2 points. Greg and Anderson. That was number 11, right?
Yep.
Greg and Anderson, 6 foot freshman.
She looks pretty good, and in a few coming years, she's going to be a really good player. This is great experience for a young girl right now. Look at the defense.
And now a timeout because of that defense. Pineview not happy. It's a 30, so we'll keep it here. 41-38, just like that, where we were saying 10 points, 8 points, they got to chip it down. The Lady Cougars have chipped it down, Brandon.
Yeah, amazing what a little bit of momentum can do on defense for you on offense. Get a breakaway, get a layup. And you're back in this game. You get a huge shot for a freshman.
All right, well, we cover football and basketball, part of VTV sports coverage. But I'll tell you what, you go to the Affinity Sports Zone, and it's all baseball, softball. Affinity Sports Zone is open 7 days a week from 10 to 10 through Saturday and 10 to 8 on Sunday. They have a large party room, 3 batting cages for baseball, and 1 for softball where you can choose slow or fast pitch. Okay, in that one softball cage. They also have a pitching cage with a radar. I've gotten clocked up to, I think, 74 in there. So don't let the cold keep you inside. Come out to the Affinity Sports Zone. I actually have loved going there.
Yeah, get ready for the softball season's coming up. Go out there and hit a few balls. I need to do that myself.
Yeah, that place is kind of hidden. It's behind Ross Dress for Less in that Lowe's shopping center near the big Strata store up there as well. Behind Sportsman's Warehouse, is that what it's called?
Yep, it's right behind Sportsman's Warehouse.
All right, so behind that, you actually literally got to drive back where you think only the dumpsters or delivery trucks would go. You got to go back there. All right, so Pineview ball with that timeout. They keep possession 2.5 minutes or so, third quarter, in a three-point game. Oh. And trying to get to the three-point shooter.
Chesney Nielsen with the hustle play right there, getting her hand on the ball.
Getting into that passing lane. I mean, you watch film on a team, you know how they like to pass it around.
In Pineview, out of a timeout, you don't want that to happen. You don't want a turnover.
Three-point shot is an air ball.
That's the third air ball from this half.
But she can make them. She's short. Oh, look at that. I like you get that rebound and go on the run. That's a travel. Oh, man.
And finally you call it.
Yeah, I don't know what she did after that. She took the ball and she kind of hit the other player. Chesney did. Did you see that? She took three steps, I think, before she even did that.
I keep saying first and second half because I watch so much college basketball. I need to keep up to one, two, three quarters.
Oh, yeah. We're in the third quarter.
Third quarter.
Trying to get it down to the corner. Boy, that defense is all over the place. And here comes Little Ross. And so you've got okay, so there's three Rosses out there. And they're all exactly 6 inches apart from each other, from 6 foot, 5'6", to 5 foot.
I know two of them are sisters. Is the other one a sister, too?
I don't know. She's a sophomore.
Okay. Katie and Tori are sisters, and they definitely have a good chemistry already, even with Tori being a freshman.
So when I refer to them, I got to go little, middle, and big. Okay? Little, I'll say Little Ross for Little Ross. I'll say medium Ross for the other Little Ross. And then Tall Ross for the six-footer. Look at that fight right there between basically two Cougars.
Stays with Pineview with the possession.
Watch this hustle play right here. Get that rebound up and rip it away.
Yeah, can you tell it's tourney ball out there, Brian?
Yes, you can. There's a lot of intensity here. A three-point shooter for Pineview decides to give it up inside. She can do that. And, nice. Just enough of the ball on that shot. And now a turnover. The freshman thought she had her guard next to her and throws it away to Newby. And Newby in the corner struggling a little bit with that ball. But she's got a wide open three. That's off, I can tell right now. And, a fast break attempt just thwarted. And now a two-point shot. Boy, that you can't give them three opportunities.
Nope. And it's happened all game. They've had three opportunities. They finally put it in. They have that big opportunity with another missed air ball three. Basically hit the backboard. And all you have to do is come up with that and go to the other side. But turning the ball over is a big issue, too.
All right, so medium to Little Ross. And left side, Draper.
Let's see if we can get Draper going. She's our leading scorer for this year.
Nice dish. And going to the free throw line, Anderson. Sorry, finish your thought.
Oh, you're fine. I was just talking about Draper. She just needs to get more involved in this game. She's your leading scorer. You need to go to her. I think that she's just waiting to get her teammates involved, and that's unselfish by her as well.
So let's see how this freshman does. Reagan Anderson, a 6 foot guard is what they have her listed as. And she seems pretty athletic. So why aren't they giving her two shots? They're not giving her two shots because the ball stayed in her hand. That's a lame interpretation of the rule. Maybe it is part of the rule, but oh my goodness, that's lame. She was definitely going up for the shot. Corner, medium Ross. Good! No!
Almost goes, but she gets the rebound and fouled.
Oh man, that's one of the rare times I am off the mark. I was just about to call that good. And I sounded like Mark there for a second. Oh, that was a big shot. And look at that, over the back, technically. I mean, getting arms tangled, and there's a foul.
Yeah, that's an anticipation call there by you. Kind of like how a ref anticipates a foul.
Yeah. Boy, that was a good shot. And there she is driving and penetrating and getting it stolen away and now getting the foul. Boy, that's a horrible turn of events right there. You drive in, and they're calling it on five for black. Never mind what I was just saying. Even Medium Ross thought it was hers. Catherine did that foul, but boy, look at that. See what she's doing with her arms. She's like, get away from me. It was almost like, not quite throwing elbows, but she's just like trying to be a little bit physical, sending a message to Pineview.
Yeah.
We've got a timeout, and it is full. So with 35 seconds left in the third quarter, it's a five-point game. 43-38, a low-scoring quarter compared to the others. We'll be right back.
At B&D RV, we are the Basin's headquarters on providing affordable, comfortable RVs that get you out of the city and into the woods. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, here at B&D, we will assist you with your purchase. Stop in today and see our large inventory.
Are you a busy mom like me with so little time, juggling so many different things that getting your oil changed is the last thing on your mind? You won't believe this. Head to L&L Express Lane. You don't need an appointment. There's a place for your kids to play, and you can use an iPad with Wi-Fi while you wait. And here's the best part. It's all done under 30 minutes or less. Come and see us at L&L's Express Lane. People you know, people who care.
Just a little bit left in the third quarter. Brian Baldwin, Brandon Jones here at Union High School in Roosevelt, where Pineview had a very long trip up here to play this game. First round of the 3A playoffs, one hosting four, and it's a five-point game where four is over one. But you know what? The Lady Cougars are showing me something tonight. They're showing a lot of grit.
Grit and toughness, just physical play. I don't expect anything less than tourney ball. You're fighting for your life out here, so that's how it's going to go.
And whenever I've watched Union play, even, you know, rival UNTN football, Union always seems to be, at, you know, out-muscling a lot of teams and getting in their head through the physical play. That right there was thrown away, though. That was my key to the second half. Don't throw it away. Take care of the ball.
I'm kind of curious. The last two plays, Tori Ross is bringing the ball in, where she's kind of the shortest one out there, and they have a lot of height on her. You think that someone with taller would be throwing the ball in.
Yeah, that's a good call right there. Is it Farnsworth? Yeah, her arms were kind of flapping around when that shot went up. Watch this pass, another pass right here underneath, and watch her arm right there, and then she goes straight up, but she made that contact before she went up.
Yeah, nothing against Tori on that. I'm just saying that you probably want to have a taller person inbounding the play.
Yeah. Ooh, in and out. And Sarah Van Allen is 1-for-3 from the line tonight.
So really good free throw shooting on the Union side, not so good on the Pineview side.
16.8 seconds. And the second free throw, she made 1-for-2 earlier and she misses both this time. Rebound, a host of Cougars for that one. 10 seconds remaining.
Smallest girl on the floor.
Draper, nope.
With the rebound.
Get that rebound, get on the floor, jump ball, timeout or something. Who does it go to?
You got a jump ball.
It goes to the Cougars. They can run an inbound play here.
Extra possession for Union right there. Hustling like they're doing all game long, and they get the ball for their team. Getting fired up.
You know, they set that picket fence, and when I've coached that, I tell the girls to get tight, and Moe just kind of goes in there and pushes Draper away from the other girl.
And they have...
Oh, no. That's the second time in a row they just throw these away.
Super big troubles of trying to get the ball inside the play. They didn't have Tori Ross inbound in there, but they did throw it away again.
And that jump ball hurts even more because guess who gets the ball to start the fourth quarter now? Yeah.
The Panthers.
Yep. All right. 5, 4, 3, 2.
I don't think
they throw it away
it.
Too. And there's the buzzer. So both teams just totally losing their head at the end of the third quarter. That ought to make for an interesting fourth quarter because it's only a five-point game. Let's take a break. We'll be back with the fourth quarter right after this on VTV.
One of the most important aspects of injury or post-surgical recovery can be physical therapy. At Ashley Regional Medical Center, you will always receive one-on-one care from our two doctors of physical therapy. They also treat neck, back, muscle, and joint pain and tension headaches. They can screen athletes for muscular imbalances and treat vertigo. And they can make custom hand or wrist braces. If you need physical therapy, ask your physician to send you to the only physical therapy that offers one-on-one care.
Okay, we are back here with the Union Cougars and the Panthers from Pineview, and it's a close game, 38-43. Got me, Brandon Jones, and Brian Baldwin here hanging out, watching the game, watching the Cougar crazies over here. Everybody getting into it. What kind of things are we going to see in this fourth quarter, Brian?
Oh, boy, we're going to see Pineview try to get their head back. Obviously, they've lost it. Akeena's back in there. And she's a great player. She's an important part to their game, but she's in foul trouble. The Lady Cougars, though, look, they're still coming out with the freshman in the middle and some of the big role players on the side and a little freshman at point guard on defense right now and little Russ.
Yeah, we'll see what kind of Russ that Keene has coming off the bench. She's been on whole quarter on the bench with the three fouls. Good defense by Union right there on the floor again.
Boy, they're you know, when it comes to those plays, Union's aggressiveness is getting them down there, and Pineview is getting the foul called on them.
It's a big cat fight with the Cougars and Panthers.
Yeah, and it's already, look at this, it's already 1-1. Boy, this is how you chip away the lead. You're already at the line at the beginning of the fourth quarter when your team only has 14 fouls. Boy, this is getting crowded in here for the boys game coming up right after this. And it's good.
It's a big shot in the fourth quarter. Oop.
Katie Ross.
Got ran over by a little kid there.
Yeah, 4 points, 2 out of 3 from the line tonight. And the second one here is good. I didn't want to get ahead of myself that time either as it rolled around the rim. It's a 3-point game. Ooh, some of my most exciting games covering teams on VTV have been in this gym. Oh my goodness, and we're set up for another one. It's gonna be Panther ball.
Oh yeah, I'm getting a little jumpy and excited, waiting for this fourth quarter to happen. It's been all I've wanted it to be.
So little Ross on defense on Newbie. And Newbie beats her in size, but you know what? If they're in front of you, you still can't do anything about it, no matter how short they are. Look at that. Pass is tipped, and now it's a jump ball, but it's going Union's way.
Union did a good job there. What Pineview has done all game long has tried to separate those people right there in the bottom and trying to get that in deep, deep, deep inside. And Union wasn't allowing it on that time. They got three people right there waiting for that pass to come in. And she had it. She didn't have it up high. She had it down low, and they took it away.
Up top, swing it right to Ross and the other Ross. And it's kicked out of bounds, but the other Ross got a hand on it. And so that was a turnover because of that.
Just these turnovers are killing Union on trying to get back in this game. I mean, it's only a 3-point game. They could have been ahead or tied if they would have just took care of the ball. Take care of the ball.
And there's a 3-point shooter. And she can make, oh, you're leaving her wide open in the corner. Watch this. She's on the left wing. Let's see if they get it to her. Swing it. Nope, high post.
She's right there and she's all alone and Union doesn't know it.
Yeah, Akeen gets a hand. Someone's got a hand in there, messes her up. And now she's over the back. Look at that.
4,000. Akeen.
Yep. Boy, she is frustrated. And you know, I don't know if I said it like I thought it earlier, but earlier when Akeen was on the floor, and I'm talking like way early in the fourth quarter, when she was on the floor, I was starting to think, wow, they're already kind of in her head. The physical nature of this game is already in her head, and they've had the lead the entire game. But that's why you play four quarters, right?
Yeah, definitely. And you can see as the game has gone on, they've kind of tried to get in her head, and that's a game plan. You know, this girl, she has 261 points and 171 rebounds this year. She is just massive, and she just has been a little bit frustrated in this game, and credit that to Union.
Well, Paige Farnsworth misses her first free throw. I believe that's like 8 for 9. I'll tally it up here in a second, but she misses her first one. High post, up, three-point shooter, it's right.
Oh, and she just missed it barely.
Rebound, though, and Sarah gets it back out. Pierce does. Left side to Sarah Vinn, back into Sarah Pierce, off the glass, good.
Pineview did a better job there right there, trying to get deep in the post, getting to go inside.
5-point game. You know, the Lady Cougars have only played 7 girls this entire game. Medium Ross in there.
Oh, and she gets it to go with a big layup.
You know, I probably ought to do her a service and call her by her name. Katie Ross for 2. Medium just doesn't fit. Oh, there's the drive, and she's going to the line. Newbie is, and look at her bend over again. I don't know if she's getting cramps or if she's just getting hit in the ribs or what, but she is in pain, but she's still giving it her all.
Yeah, just a strong slashing play.
Yeah, I like that. You take it in, and Ross, yeah, got her hand in there. Boy, Newby brought that ball way down low, though. You got to keep that ball high. Off the front of the rim. Her first free throw is missed.
You win and lose games on the free throw line, and right now Panthers' problem is definitely free throws. They're doing a good job of getting the ball inside, but they got to hit free throws.
Up and rebounded on the miss by Roosevelt, but ripped away. And another Pineview player taking her time getting off the floor. That's Sarah Pierce. Now she's on defense as Union gets the ball away, and she is very frustrated, Sarah Pierce is. She got the foul call right there, and that's four.
Yeah, that's a big, big foul right there. They got four fouls on her, and she'll probably sit.
Boy, she came out on fire hitting the first two shots of the game, Sarah Pierce did. And so far tonight, not bad. I mean, 12 points, but when you score the first four, then only have eight the rest of the way, that's adjustment in defense.
I just got to really like the physical nature of Union basketball and Union girls. They are just in every play and hitting every free throw. I don't know if I've seen a game where every free throw is just going in, especially in tournament play. What a great form here.
7 for 8.
And another one.
8 for 9 for Paige Farnsworth. It's a one-point game, 45-44. Pineview ball, they have led the entire way. Crossover, left, 5.5, fourth quarter. Swing it to the three-point shooter, up, and it looks good, but it's short. Ross coming down. Body's hitting the floor, but they get right back up. Oh, no, that's the second time that's happened in the last couple minutes where, Ross throws it. It gets tipped, and then the offensive player trying to get it tips it right out of bounds, and it's a turnover because of that. Boy.
Yep. The Panthers are trying to get some threes on the outside, but all they need to do is use that height and get inside in the middle, but they're not doing that.
Three-point attempt.
It's a three-point, and it's not going.
Ross, rebound. Push it. Right to left, Katie Ross, up. Oh, off the side of the board. Now this girl's fast. Newbie, you got to catch up. Watch her break. Oh, look at that. Berge, she gets right in front of her. And if you send her to the line, she's 0-for-1. So a newbie, you're taking the gamble here, fouling instead of giving her that free throw. Watch her just get in front. That's what I like, making sure she doesn't have that path to the basket.
Yeah, and getting a hard enough foul where she can't make it either, so it's not an and-one play.
And are they saying it was down?
Oh.
Well, I'm confused too, just like that coach. Well, the body contact was before the shot. Another three-point attempt, no good. Boy, after making her first two, I think she's 0-for-4. 4:45, fourth quarter.
Yeah, the Panthers have definitely struggled on the three-point line today. We want to see him actually get it inside. Maybe stop shooting these threes and trying to win the game other ways.
Oh, Berge gets it knocked out of bounds. That's a good block, and that block is by Kenya Schoen, who offensively only has 2 points, but defensively, she just made a great play right there. 4:33, fourth quarter. Whoa, body's hitting the floor. And
Tori Haas barely gets it in with an errant pass there, but it's okay.
Oh, that's for the lead.
Oh, and the three does not go.
But that was a tough shot. And now a steal. Look at
steal
that.
Steal, and Tori Ross gets on the ball.
Who are they calling? Look at this. People all over
people
the floor.
Down, injured.
I don't even know what the call is right now.
I don't think you can call a foul. They all were just hustling for the ball. All three of them came converged together, and I think that she hit her ribs.
Let's see what the play is if we have a replay. I think the fans should probably. Okay, so here's the steal, and that's a clean steal. One girl on the ground just lost her balance. You've got little Ross, and really, it basically, if you call a foul, the girl who's hurt is the one you call the foul on, because she came in to Ross. Ross was just going for the ball, and the other girl rolled over Ross. I didn't see any problem there, but that girl came in a little bit later. Let's take a break while she's on the floor.
It's
that's given me confidence to know that I have the skills, I have the knowledge. It helps me reach one of my goals of becoming a director in the HR field.
I'm right here in my tribal community. You don't have to leave, and you're still getting a high quality education. Students that I advise and I teach become family, and I hope that they consider me a part of their family.
I think Kenya Schoen will be fine, but she was on the ground, and they did call the foul on, they called the foul on Moei, who is the other one diving for the ball besides the Ross here. Is that Tori Ross with the missed free throw? But so three of them on the ground, one leaves with the injury, one gets the foul, and the other one's shooting the free throw.
Yeah, Tori has a big chance to tie the game up right here with a free throw.
And it is no
good.
Rebound, Pineview.
And Aquin is back in the game for this 4 minute and 10 stretch. If I'm Union, I'm trying to get her fifth foul. Get her out of there.
Inside, look at that, and it goes. It's a three-point game.
Moei.
Trying to scoot some stuff under the bleachers so people can walk by us.
We're getting trampled all over here.
350, 47-44, Pineview with the lead. They've had it all game. It started 2-0, 4-0, 4-3, and after that they kind of ran off with a big lead at 22-10 after the Cougars did tie it at 10. Ross. All the way across, they're getting an open shot. Let's see if it's tied. Nope. Ooh. Short following the shot. Pineview's got it. All right, we've got another girl on the floor.
That looks like a foul on Union this time.
Yep, let's see. Oh, boy. Yeah, she's just standing in the way where she shouldn't. All right, so at the free throw line is Moei, and that's five fouls, actually, on number five for Union, and that is Catherine Ross. So is it? No, that's three fouls. I'm sorry.
She's just going to take a little breather. Yep.
And the first free throw is good.
That's their first free throw made in a very long time.
.326 fourth quarter, a four-point game. And the fans are letting her know that she shot a couple air balls earlier. But you know what? She makes both free throws. They're good. 8 points. And it's a five-point game. Ross, look at that screen. She got in there, but nothing could do. Over to the other Ross, Tori. Oh, look at that corner. The ball got there a little late. Draper. Looking for something. They've got to score. This has been a very low scoring second half. Ross drives in, back to Draper.
Draper's
for three.
Wide open.
Oh, short. Boy, they're tired out there. That's three in a row that have been off the front of the rim from all sorts of Lady Cougars.
Yeah, all been just short. You can tell they've just got the fatigue going on in the fourth quarter. Let's see how they step it up and get in this last 2 minutes and 48 seconds.
Well, Pineview is content with just running the clock out. They want to go back victorious. They got a five-point lead. They've had the lead the entire game, except for maybe one tie. Driving in, up and under. That's a great pass to the corner, and that's not a good shot. Off right. Draper, rebound, down.
Tori.
Ross taking on a girl twice her size. Up, no good.
Oh,
rebound. Pineview.
A good attempt there by Tori Ross to get that layup. Just couldn't get it to fall.
And
good
look at
defense.
That defense. Ross.
Throws it to Ross.
Down to Draper. Draper.
Draper's fouled.
She's going to the line. So Draper tonight has just 7 points. Her first trip to the free throw line tonight. 2:09 on the clock. She needs to hit both of these.
Yeah. She got fouled a little hard on that play, so she couldn't get the and one, but they've been good all day on the free throw line, so.
First one's good. Four-point game. Let's watch her take it in. It's just off a foot. I mean, you could say that there's contact or whatever, but that's just great defense. And she got ball there at first, but a lot of arm after that. So Draper just kept pushing that shot up, and she created that foul. 4-point game. And no good, but rebound Pineview. And Pineview, she kind of took a step before she put that dribble down, and now going to the line is Akeen for Pineview.
You know, really not a bad foul there. They haven't been very good at the line. Clock stopped. You're down 3 or 4. Trying to get them to miss the ball here. Oops. Union's really got a rebound, though.
All right, so 2:07, fourth quarter. Akeen at the line, and she's had the Cougars in her head all day. She misses. Put back from Pineview. No good. Rebound. Put back again is good.
Again, 3 chances there for the Panthers. 3 chances for Union to rebound and just couldn't get it done.
And a timeout, and it's a full timeout for the Cougars. And they're down 6. This game all of a sudden has kind of gotten away from them. So we're going to take a break. We're going to be back with probably the rest of the fourth quarter. Keep it here at VTV.
In Utah, 562 people died by suicide last year. In 3 consecutive years, 151 youth died by suicide, and only 1 was currently in treatment. What would you do if someone you knew was in a mental health crisis? Learn how to identify signs and access resources and support. Northeastern Counseling Center is offering a 1-day mental health first aid class, and it's free. Contact Northeastern Counseling for information for future classes and be part of the solution.
At Moon Lake Electric, we are a locally owned cooperative with a deep history of providing dependable and affordable electric service to its customers for over 75 years. With a state-of-the-art electrical system, we are setting a standard for excellence in the electric utility industry. We are proud to call this place home, and we are happy to support our local schools and athletes. Find and like us on Facebook for energy-saving tips. Moon Lake Electric, keeping the power on.
All right, we are back with 1:53 on the clock, 45-51. Panthers are kind of in control right now. Union's definitely talking it over in their huddle, what they can do. I think, you know, I wouldn't mind if they just went to fouling, because Panthers have just been so bad at free throws. So we'll see how they can do.
Got to get those rebounds as well, though.
Yeah.
2 points ago, they had a great opportunity to get a rebound. Torrey all the way up to Draper. Draper in the corner to the other Ross, Katie, and she loses it off a foot, and Pineview with 90 seconds is feeling pretty comfortable right now until Ross comes up. Nice, tapped out of bounds, stays Pineview.
The Unions, they're not gonna give up. The girls are not gonna give up. They're not gonna get down on themselves. They're gonna play this ball game until the end.
Their first action tonight, well, maybe not. Draper's coming out, and Berge's back in. Defensive pressure, tapped away, or attempted to tap away again. Look at that, they left somebody wide open. She's driving in. This may not be a good decision, because they could have wasted some more time. With a minute 12 going to the line for Pineview is Sarah Van Allen. She's only 1 for 4 from the line. That's why I'm saying it's not a very good decision by her. She's like, whoa, I see a big open space, but when you're trying to take time off the clock.
Yeah, Union's got to look for those people that haven't made free throws all game and just foul.
But it proves good for Pineview in one shot. 4 points now for Allen.
And Panthers, they faced a lot of adversity in this game, a lot of physical play. A lot of them have been hurt, but they stepped up and responded in a big way.
Second one's good. All right, so Katie Ross to Torrey, back to Katie. Katie inside, and she gets, oh boy, this is where the height disadvantage hurts you. Because you drive in, I mean, you don't have much height to work in there at all. And
yeah, she creates the jump ball there and gets the ball back for the Panthers. Pineview in control right here.
And the pass goes off Pineview. Yeah, I'd like to see that one again. I wasn't sure who that went off of, but it looked like to me it went off Pine View. But they have a better angle down there than I do. Pine View to inbound again, 1 minute even. Fourth quarter, it is an 8-point game. It was just 1 point at 45-44, so since then, it's 8-1, Pine View. The Cougars have just not scored much this half. Defense has been pinched on both ends. Akeen loses it. That's what you want. Torrey Ross, just to take it in. Oh, man, see, that's what I'm talking about. You can't create a shot against someone 8 inches taller than you when you take it inside, so you bring that ball down to try to make a pass, and they've just put their hands on it. That's what's hard about being so outmatched height-wise.
Yeah, they just have way too much height down there, Brian. They gotta come up with something different there. But that's a freshman mistake. She kind of just had four girls to pass there. She could have passed it back and got it to go to her offense.
Oh, Draper tries to get it. They throw it away, and Moe, or whatever her name is just going to dribble it out. Back to Newby, 33 seconds, and the Cougars going to send Newby to the free throw line. This is kind of the last-ditch effort, down eight. Down eight are the Cougars, and I think this game, honestly, just assessing it, I think the Cougars played with so much energy, but you saw those three-point shots toward the end. They were all short off the front of the rim. They are tired, and sometimes that's not enough to beat a team that probably is better and at least more athletic, height-wise. But the Cougars, the Lady Cougars, man, give it to them. They sent a message to Pine View saying, we're not going to go down without a fight. That one is good.
A lot to overcome down there with the height and with the offensive rebounds that they've been getting all the game long. It's hard to win a game when that happens. But, yeah, the credit to Union, they did not give up. They're a hard-fighting team.
Look at that.
Back a three.
Don't give up too quick. 54-48, 6 points now, but 17.5 seconds left. And it looks like it's a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it here. All right, we'd like to thank our sponsors. Boy, I mean, this game got intense, but we'd like to thank our sponsors. Northeastern Counseling Center, professionals offering hope, help, and healing. Northeastern Counseling has provided mental health and substance abuse services to the citizens of Northeastern Utah since the mid-80s. How about BNDRV? Tonight's pregame coverage was brought to you by BNDRV. Whether you're looking for your first RV or your last, BNDRV will assist you in your purchase. Stop in at 1570 West Highway 40 in Vernal to check out our on-the-lot inventory at BNDRV. JCS Construction, proud to support VTV's coverage of local high school sports. JCS. And, of course, you've seen ads for many of these companies, but, you know, if you ever are over there, please thank them for supporting local high school sports. Draper all over on defense, but they get it down, and a timeout Pine View with 12 seconds left. It's a full, but we're going to keep it here. 54-48. Remember, the boys are playing Snow Canyon immediately after this game. Pine View will move on to play the winner of Juab and Morgan Thursday in Cedar City, and they've earned a trip there by beating the number one seed in Union here on Union's floor. And maybe I'm getting ahead of myself, but it's a 6-point game with 12 seconds left.
Yeah, big shot, Bergie. She says, I don't want to go home yet. She drills that three. Let's see what they can do. Maybe they can, you know, get a foul. They haven't been hitting free throws all the game, so they can maybe extend this game with missed free throws.
Yep. Utah State University starter, complete your education right here in the Uinta Basin and be an Aggie in your hometown. Programs are available in business, nursing, education, natural resources, and many more. Apply now for the best scholarship opportunities and course selection. Visit uintabasin.usu.edu for details. And once again, this has been a full minute timeout. One more sponsor that I have not mentioned tonight, Pilot Thomas. With the merger of Pilot Logistics and Thomas Petroleum, customers can get both Chevron and Conoco oil and lube products. Race fuel and cylinder propane refills are available at the Naples location. Pilot Thomas Logistics continues to offer local services such as fuel and lubes delivery just as they did for years under Western Petroleum. Pine View to inbound with 12 seconds left and fight for the ball, but it's going to go Pine View's way if it's a jump, but it's a foul.
It's a
foul on Draper.
Not much time went off the clock.
Wait.
What are they calling here?
Union seems to know. Oh, okay, Pineview's just not going to fill the lane.
Okay.
So with 10 seconds left, 54-48 at the line, we have Moe.
Which surprises me that they don't fill the lane, because what they've done, they've missed free throws but got rebounds, but you're not going to get a rebound very good with nobody there.
I'm sorry, this isn't Moe. Yeah, you're right. This isn't Moe. This is Fiami. Natasha Fiami, a senior. She's in there to close out this game. She hasn't played a whole lot tonight, but she does have 2 points, and she's looking for three right here. Nope. So she misses both. Down with Ross in a hurry. In the middle, she's going to spin into the zone and up off the glass. No good. Rebound.
Puts it back.
Nope.
She gets fouled, though.
Yep, going to the line with 1.7 seconds left. So is there a seven-point shot anywhere?
I don't know if I've seen anything crazier than that. Reggie Miller is the best thing I can think of getting pretty much 8 points in 3 seconds. So, but you got to like the effort out there of Union. They are not giving up.
First one's missed by Cassie Houston. 2 points for her tonight.
Yeah, you can get in a mindset and say, hey, this is over, and not play until the very end. But that's not the character of this team.
No, that's the game right there. Union fights literally to the last tenth of a second. Pineview comes in here and beats Union on their home floor. And they head back to St. George, and the rest of the tournament for them is a little half-hour drive. So I'll tell you what, they came in here and they did really well against this Union Cougar team. No doubt that the Pineview Panthers are a talented girls team. A lot of good things from them. No doubt that the Union Cougars have a lot to look forward to with one Ross coming up the ranks. One Ross, though, just finished her season tonight. And I believe her career, right? Number 5, Catherine Ross. So seniors on this team playing their last game, Catherine Ross, Shayla Draper, Alyssa Berge, Paige Farnsworth, and Cassie Houston. You guys gave it a great effort, and we enjoyed watching you play. The boys coming up in just a matter of a few moments. I don't know the time exactly, but keep it here to the live stream or VTV for coverage of the Union Cougar boys and the Snow Canyon boys team.